Hello, 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 everybody. My name is Steve Ford, and welcome to Learn English Live 35. Today, I have a question from Manashur from Tajikistan. Thanks for leaving it on my website. You can also leave your question at the link below this video, all of you who are watching this lesson. Let's listen to Manashur's question.
Hi, Steve. My name is Manashur, and I am from Tajikistan. Could you tell, please, about word choice? Thank you.
So, learning English is a never-ending process. It's a never-ending story, and that's a good thing because you can always improve, you can always polish your English. When you reach the advanced level, there are some words that look similar but have completely different meanings. How was the concert last night? Oh, it was so funny. Now, did that person actually want to say fun? Because fun means that it was amusing, that it was pleasant, it was a very enjoyable time that they had. Funny is funny ha-ha. Funny is something which is humorous, like a comedy, like a movie. It was very funny. That comedian, he's so funny, he makes me laugh. Funny can also mean strange. John called in sick today. That's funny, I saw him at the bar. Boring, annoying, let's take an example. What do you think of the new teacher? Oh, he's so boring. He's so annoying. We have two separate meanings here. Boring means, yeah, he's putting me to sleep. He's annoying means that he's very irritating. He does something which gets on your nerves, gets under your skin. Educate and bring up. In some languages, the same verb is used for both. But in English, we have a difference here. Parents bring up their child. They give them food. They give them a place to live. And teachers educate children. They just give them an education. They give them the information. There is a difference. If you say, I feel, you're talking about your feelings. If you say, I feel myself, then you're touching yourself. You're feeling yourself. Google I feel myself and see what you find. It's all porn sites. However, in American English, because of popular music like rap, it is common for people to say, I feel you. I feel you, which is a short form for I feel for you or I understand how you feel. So that's something that you can add to make your English sound more native-like. It's informal, but used a lot. So you'll hear a lot of people here, especially young people, saying, oh, I'm so down today. I feel you. What they're saying is, I feel for you. I know how you feel. Last one, fag in the US and fag in the UK. I was watching an interview with a young British musician, and he was in his early 20s, so I'm pretty sure that they still use fag. I didn't know. I thought because of all those American movies that they didn't use fag anymore to mean cigarette, but they still do. I was surprised. He said, I was going to go out and have a fag. In American English, it's different. So imagine you're walking down the street. Somebody comes up to you and they say, fag. In the UK, they would either say, sorry, I don't have any, or yes, here you go. If you do that in the United States, you walk up to someone, you say, fag, they're going to say, who are you calling a fag? So fag in the US means homosexual. And to be politically correct, we don't use that word anymore. It's very pejorative. It's very insulting. And as you know, here in North America, we're very politically correct. So that word is totally out of the picture. Well, everybody, I hope you enjoyed my lesson about word choice. Words that look very similar but have a slight difference. And I will post a quiz for this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I look forward to our next Learn English Live lesson. Bye for now.